Today we have come to commission a new administrative block, rector's office inclusive, offices inclusive, some important halls inclusive, and other facilities built by our own humble, hardworking, and forward-looking rector. With this structure, a very significant addition has been made to the structure of developments in the seminary in the last 40 years.
Unless the Lord builds the house, in vain do the laborers labor. From the first day of this work, God has never failed to show himself a faithful God, whose mercies and love endure forever. Your grace, we wish to welcome you in a special way for carving out time from your tight schedule to be with us this afternoon for the blessing of this new complex. As I have always said, you are the reason behind our smile and the inspiration behind our progress. Because you're a visionary leader who loves to dream big and make it happen, we, your children, have learned to follow in your example, your grace. At the beginning of this administration, you gave us a task which we took to heart, to give All Hallows a class. In the past 3 years, we toiled speedily and unceasingly to actualize that dream of a new All Hallows that belongs to a higher class. Through the many works you did, and through the formation strategy we adopted for our young seminarians. As I gradually come to the end of my administration, I most humbly present to you this administrative block two, which we built with class, while asking for your blessing.
So today, we celebrate Our Lady of the Holy Rosary. And I'm happy that it is today this facility is being blessed. And we pray the invisibility of God, which he now and again gives us through intercession of our Blessed Mother, will come down upon this institution. And that the invisibility of God will come down upon Anambra State and upon the children of God. That the invisibility of God will give us peace and sustainable progress. That the invisibility of God will wipe our tears and chart a new course, a new history for us. Man has powers, but God has the ultimate power. We trust in God. He has the final word. We call upon him to say that final word that will give us peace, that will give us life, that will protect us through Christ our Lord.